Here's an experiment with a person and robot task. We actually didn't do any special programming for this, but the force control in the arms make it tolerant of...
Wow, look at that.
And obviously if you have a dog-like robot and a human-like robot, it seems like you should take them out
for a walk.
I'm not sure who was walking whom for that. Now, everybody thinks we only do legged robots, so no one has seen this. You guys are the first. This is the debut presentation.
Oh, wow, look at this.
Of what I think will be a nightmare-inducing robot, if you're anything like me.
Oh, my God,
this is an experiment in combining wheels with legs with a very dynamic system that is balancing itself all the time, and it has a lot of knowledge of how to throw its weight around, which it uses to help stabilize itself.
Wow.
Here we're just testing out the various capabilities. This is much more efficient than a legged robot. It can carry a reasonably heavy load on a small footprint. And it's basically an exercise in seeing if we can do something like the humanoid that has less degrees of freedom, eventually could be less expensive, but still have a significant capability. We call this handle because it's supposed to handle objects eventually. Here it's showing off.
Oh, yeah. X Games.
I think I'm probably just about out of time. I'm out of time, so I won't go through these other slides. Maybe they'll come up in the discussion. But we brought one of the robots with us today.
Oh, cool.
This is Spotmini, and this is Sec Davis, the robot handler. And he's driving the robot around with a joystick and a little Xbox controller. The robot's doing all its own control and thinking with onboard computers. All Seth is doing is giving it speed and direction. One of the cool things about this robot is it can walk with a bunch of different gates. Here it's a walking gate. Here it's doing a pacing gate. Pacing, in an animal, pacing means the legs on the left are together and the legs on the right. Here it's trotting. A robot like this is omnidirectional, which means that you can drive it sideways, fore and aft, turn in place. You want to do tall and short? The controller for this robot is really interesting. I'm not going to talk about it too much now, but later we can tell you more about it. But there's a style of programming called sequential composition, which means that the programmers can work on really narrow functionality and have the pieces go together to enable a very wide range of capability. So the program that made this robot do the various gates generalizes across walking tall and short and that kind of stuff. The robot has an arm. Some people think it has a head and a neck, but we call it an arm and a hand. It's actually got a sensor in the hand, and a little bit later, you want to do the chicken head thing? Then we call this the chicken head move, where it's stabilizing the hand while it moves the body. I just realized that, I don't know if it's politically acceptable, but we really should call this motion twerking, I think. It looks a lot like twerking, doesn't it?
Oh, shit.
Let's see, what's next? It's a kind of a show-off robot, so it has some dynamic gigs. Here it's hopping on diagonal legs. It can also jog.
It's quieter than the last one.
And you want to pick up the can? So it's going to pick up this can using a semi-autonomous function. Seth's going to get it so that it's close, and then he's going to look around with a sensor that it's got in the hand. And then pick it up. Now, one of the engineers who worked on the can pickup is a descendant of Singularity in the sense that he's the son of Dan Berry, who is one of your...
Dan, and Dan's head of robotics division at SU, or track at SU, yeah.
And he works at our company. Anything else, Seth? That's it.
Wow. So is Spotmini going to be here through the lunchtime?
Yes, we're going to have it at lunch, so if you want to watch it more closely, or Seth will show you how to drive it if you want, you can drive it.
How cool is that, guys, huh?